Hello everyone, it's me, Dr. Dalvie, your friendly Dr. To the Barrio and Scholarships Aficionado. I'm gonna share with you three easy steps on how you can maximize the day before the NMAT so you get a score of 99 plus on your NMAT. Whoa! Oh yes, is that possible? Very much, and that's what I'm gonna share with you. Love, love, love! Many times when we are preparing for examinations, we see the many months, the many weeks before the actual exam day as the most important. Sometimes we take for granted the more crucial days, which are the few days before the exam, the day before the exam, and the actual examination day. So now, I'm gonna share with you on how you can spend the day before your NMAT day in a good way so that you can maximize each hour of it, okay? Let's contextualize. I took the NMAT last 2010. I was already doing the INTARMED program at the time at the University of the Philippines Manila, UP Manila. So to be honest, at the time, I didn't face much pressure with the NMAT because technically, I was already in med school at the time. Taking the NMAT for people like me in the INTARMED program was more of part of formality rather than as a prerequisite for admission to med school, since technically, we were already in UP Med at the time. I'm a very goal-oriented person, so at the time, I had to prioritize. Do I focus on NMAT? Do I allow it to eat all of my study time? Or do I focus on my subjects at UP Manila? To be honest, the decision was very easy for me. I focused on my subjects. I focused on my examinations. I focused on the requirements of my subjects at UP Manila. Why? Because I had scholarships to maintain. And my scholarships required me to maintain high grades. That is why I studied for the NMAT for only 2 days. And thank God I was able to get a beautiful score. Now, what I will be sharing with you are three easy steps on how you can spend the day before the NMAT day in the best way that you can. And I am speaking from experience since I only studied for 2 days. Easy step number one, lightly review subjects that are your weak points. Essential in preparing for examinations is knowing your strengths and your weaknesses. It's just important to do that. For me, I knew that I did not have to study as much for the sciences and math part of the NMAT because then I had a solid background on sciences and math, biology, chemistry, physics, because I graduated at the Philippine Science High School. And in our high school, we pretty much covered everything that we needed to know for the NMAT. So I was already confident on that part, to be very honest. Especially math. I mean, math is something I love. I mean, if I didn't go to the INTARMED program, my options at that time were applied math, major in finance at the Ateneo, and applied physics at UP Diliman. Yeah, I really love the sciences and math. I spent the day before the NMAT reviewing social sciences. I knew then that that's my weakness. I mean, super ultra mega weakness. In high school, the only social sciences that we studied were history, economics, both of which I would say are not heavily tested in the NMAT. A lot of the topics in the social sciences part of the NMAT would be more of psychology. So that's something that I didn't know much about at that time. I mean, I know about human behavior, but theories, terms, you know, the jargon, I'm not familiar with them. So I spent the day before the NMAT reviewing lightly psychology. What material did I use? The internet. I just Googled concepts, basic concepts in psychology, and to be honest, it was helpful. A good number of the topics that I reviewed on that day appeared on the NMAT, but it was just impossible to review everything. But at least I was able to boost up my points. And it would be very beneficial if you would focus on your weakness the day before the exam. And by focusing, I do not mean that you read an entire book overnight, because that's just impossible. What I can tell you to do is to basically just go over reviewers very lightly, refresh ideas, refresh concepts that you feel like, don't know much about this anymore, yeah, focus on those, especially your weakness, the subjects that you feel like you don't know much about. So for people who don't feel confident about mathematics, probably refresh on the formula, refresh the concepts, how to do, how to calculate, how to compute, those kinds of things. People who don't feel confident in biology, yeah, lightly review the terms, the concepts, but don't overdo the review part because you don't want to stress yourself out because you're gonna take the NMAT the next day, so don't overstress yourself, okay? Just lightly review, just confidently, lightly, calmly review the concepts. That's what I did and that worked for me. Easy step number two, sleep early. It's very important that you get a good amount of sleep before the actual NMAT day. I mean, how could you take an exam in the best way if you don't have the energy, if you lack sleep? I always say that I like dreaming when sleeping, especially when I have an examination the next day, because dreaming is that time when your mind consolidates everything, all the information that it received the past day. So I highly suggest that you do not engage in an all-nighter. It's just impossible to do that. I mean, if it works for you, go for it. I mean, we all have different learning styles, but for a normal human being with a normal human physiology, it's just impossible to take the NMAT and perform well if you didn't have enough sleep, if you didn't have good sleep, and if you don't have the energy at all. So please do get a good sleep. For people who will ask how long should the sleep be, I suggest that you do the normal hours that you sleep. Don't oversleep, don't undersleep, just the useful for you. The exam day is not the time to try something new. The exam day is not the time to try something out of the routine. So please do sleep in your normal, usual hours, okay? For me, I sleep for a minimum of 8 hours a day, every day. And one thing, the examination happens so early, so I suggest that you actually wake up early so that you don't be late for the examination, especially if you're taking the exam in Manila. I mean, Manila traffic's just beyond imagination. So please get a good sleep and so you can wake up early so that you won't be late for your NMAT. This is not the time to be late, my friends. Correct? Very good. Easy step number three, believe in yourself. You might say that, why is he saying this? I mean, you want a more technical advice. Well, believe me, this actually works. What you think will happen becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy. So if you believe in yourself, and if you're a person of religion, if you believe in what your God has given you, then there's a higher chance that you'll end up getting a better score on your NMAT. I mean, if you will just fill your mind with fear, disappointment that you haven't studied enough, I mean, what kind of mood would you have on your actual exam day? Just imagine taking the exam in a very sad, gloomy mood. I mean, how could you get a good score? I suggest that you believe in yourself, fill your mind with good thoughts. I'm gonna do well, I'm gonna get a good score, I'm gonna get a 99 plus on this NMAT, even if you did study enough, so that you help yourself, so you help every fiber of your being, every cell that you have, to work towards that goal. Okay? I mean, who else would cheer for you other than yourself? Come on, believe in yourself that you can get a good score. This is not the time to cram anymore. This is not the time to be disappointed. This is not the time to tell yourself that, oh, why did you not study enough? Why did you go on that date? Why did you watch that movie? Why did you do this and that? Why did you not just study each and every second of the day? Well, you know, it's already done. Nothing you can do. You enjoyed the time, correct? You can't take it back. Just let it be. Now is the time to believe in yourself that you can get the best score possible. I mean, learn from my story. Who would have thought that I would become an intermed student? Who would have thought that I could get the highest possible score in NMAT? Who would have thought that I would be where I am now, you know? I mean, if you knew me from before, it's just impossible for you to imagine that I am a doctor sitting in front of you. But a big part of that is believing in myself, believing in what God has given me, believing in everything that I can be, okay? Yes. So those are the three easy steps on how you can maximize your NMAT. I pray that you get the highest score possible so that you can enter your dream medical school. To help you beef up your application so that you can enter your dream medical school, I'm gonna share with all of you in my next vlogs how to ace your interview so that you can enter your dream medical school. tips on deciding which medical schools to go to, and tips on how to get scholarships for medical school so you can study medicine for free, just like me. Correct. And so make sure to follow me on Instagram and Facebook so that you can be updated on those vlogs. And please, let's help one another. Write down in the comment section below, yes, down there, your personal tip on how to get the highest NMAT score possible. Correct, let's help one another. Share your tips. I'm sure we all have something to put on the table. So share your tip so that we can all learn from one another. Correct, very good. Thank you for watching. I wish you all the best on your NMAT. Believe in yourself. God bless you. For more videos on scholarships, studying, and so many more, please subscribe to my channel, Dr. Dalvie, and wait for my next vlog. Woo! Love, love, love.